The project is designed to promote a healthy diet among the youth. It's part of a new school feeding program. According to authorities, the project comes at a time when malnutrition is on the increase and poor nutrition is said to be at the root of many non-communicable diseases like cancer and diabetes.
Tele-foods is a program of the FAO and it has been in existence for a while. But we believe it is very important to target schools as we said for a very long time ago that we wish to connect schools to agriculture in a more significant way. We purchase implements, tools, seeds, and various forms of assistance to donate to schools. Some schools were selected, and we are hoping to continue the selection of schools as the years go by. So in September, we will be providing this assistance to the schools. And thanks to the FAO for that kind of assistance.
Mr. Jn Baptiste says under the new initiative, seeds and other food production items will be provided to the schools by the government in order to help beef up their agriculture science programs.
We are also in discussions on work that is currently ongoing in relation to the meat processing facility, also our diagnostic facility. You will remember 2 weeks ago, we held some workshops on the early warning systems for food security in St. Lucia. And also, we have started a process of completing our food and nutrition security policy for St. Lucia. We also have a program called the Tele-Foods Project, which will be unveiled sometime in September of this year. So these are just some of the programs, some of the very important programs that we are working with the FAO on, and we are thankful for the assistance.
Jose Graziano da Silva has taken the helm of the Food and Agriculture Organization formally. He is pushing for a renewed focus on food security.
I have to say that's the first time in Santa Lucia, but the second time was my friend here, Minister Jn Baptiste. We met before in Argentina, 2011, discussing these issues about food security and agriculture development. I'm glad to be here to present the new things that FAO is promoting in the Caribbean. We presented the upgrade, the minister, on the program of zero hunger that we are implementing in Antigua and Barbuda. And we agreed to push for one of the most important projects in this program, that is the school feed program. With local products pushes from local farmers.
FAO authorities are facilitating a zero hunger initiative. It's coming at a time when statistics indicate that an estimated 925 million people suffer from chronic hunger globally.
There is a zero hunger program that we are promoting across the region that addresses very critical dimensions of the food insecurity. In St. Lucia, there has been an increase in the prevalence of undernourishment, partly because of the impact of the banana industry, trade impacts, but also the disease impacts that were mentioned. Therefore, we are looking, how can we fill the spaces that have been created by this 31% decline in the banana industry? How can we increase incomes and improve the livelihoods of especially the rural producers and rural communities that are feeling the impact of a global economic decline, higher food prices, impacts of diseases within their communities. So we are mounting this Zero Hunger Challenge program that addresses all of these dimensions.
The Food and Agriculture Organization was one of the first United Nations agencies to be created after World War II to address the worldwide need for food in the face of short supplies. For the DBS News World, I am Don Nicholas reporting.